Hey, it's Kev. Ever notice that some Blender people are totally obsessed with donuts and some want to learn Houdini? This is a short and condensed version of a longer and much more detailed video that you can watch for free on my Patreon. It's linked below. Anyway, enough of that. Let's go. The first thing you want to do here is throw down a torus. That's kind of a donut already, so you're like 90% there. If you give it more resolution, you can get a better looking donut, so do that. The donut is halfway through the floor now, so we fix that right off the bat. I keep it procedural here using a match size sop, which is short for surface operator. Next, we leverage Side Effects Labs to give us some snow. There are lots of ways to do this, but this one is pretty fast and gives us nice controls for free, so why not use it? Like, you don't always have to flex. Once we get the look we want, we separate the donut from the icing to keep our work tidy. Then, we color the icing with that annoying pink and the donut with whatever color a donut is. Like, I'm not Home Depot, so I don't have that special name for that shade. But after we decide on the colors, we scatter some points on the icing. Houdini makes this super simple. Then, we model some sprinkles. And that part takes like less than a minute, and then we instance those sprinkles onto the points that we just scattered. Attributes are the Dark Lord of Houdini, and we use that power here to randomize the rotation and colors of the sprinkles. I go into that a bit deeper in the longer video below. Now, leveraging the power of native proceduralism like geometry nodes in Blender, but in a program built that way from the ground up, we can distort our donut at the top and watch everything we've done simply follow the changes we make. This works for everything from modeling donuts to destroying planets. There are powerful copy tools in Houdini, so we use one of them here to duplicate the donuts and just make a lot more. And then we rotate to add some variety. We could duplicate or make attribute-driven changes to each one of these, but for this, nah. Once we find a happy place, we split out the parts so we can bring them in separately to Solaris, where we light and render the scene. This lets us break up the pieces so it's simple to give them different Material X shaders. Again, we could do this with attributes and calls in USD, but I like to keep things simple here. We throw down a grid for the floor so these donuts don't float like they do at 3 a.m. after a rough night. If you get that reference, you've actually experienced life off the internet, and you're my kind of people. Once we have that, we go into Solaris and play with USD. This is kind of where it's all going and where we need to be. We import what we need, create the camera, add some lights, in this case an HDR image and an area light, and then build the shaders. Since we broke out the pieces, we can just make shaders like we do in Blender and then assign them to each piece separately. Then set our depth of field if we want, add a karma lop, set our render settings, hit render to end play, sit back, wait, and go watch the longer and more in-depth video on Patreon for free if you follow me there. I have like an ebook and whatever, but no pressure. That's it. Donuts and Houdini. Have a great day.